And now we will learn how to record credit card transactions. It is so simple in the QuickBooks file that we have set up for personal finance. It's exactly the same as bank account transactions. First, use the register of the credit card account to record the transaction. Make sure you record all the relevant information like the when and the who and the what and the how and the why, and put the money amount into the correct column. Then you can check your results in the trial balance. For example, let's imagine on June 7th, Joe charged a delivery with FedEx on his Capital One credit card for $100, and the number that came out of the credit card machine onto the slip, which is his receipt and proof, is number 12345. Let's take a look at how we would record this. Since he used his Capital One credit card, we will click Capital One from the icon bar and the Capital One register window opened up. The date was June 7th. I believe the number on the credit card slip was 12345. 12345. The payee was FedEx. And here they are. And the reason we charged this money, or the service, let's say, that he received, was delivery expense. You must be very careful to put the money amount in the charge column. And I believe the amount he charged was $100. So we will put in $100. Now, when we click record, the Capital One credit card now has a balance of $100. We can click on the trial balance to take a look at the results. And we see for the first time, Capital One shows up onto the trial balance for the first time as $100, and delivery expense also shows up for the first time as $100. Now let's try this one. June 8 paid the electric bill with Joe's Capital One credit card, $250, and the number that came out from the credit card slip was 778899. That could also be the confirmation number if he paid it online. So, in the Capital One register, again, we'll put June 8th. The reference number is either the confirmation number or the number on the slip, 778899. 778899. The payee was Con Edison, because here in New York, Con Edison is whom we buy the electricity from. And the reason we bought it, the reason for the charge, is electric expense. And the money amount of the charge was $250. After we click record, we notice the balance of Capital One has increased to $350. We also notice that even though Capital One is listed here as $350, electric expense shows up in the trial balance for the first time as the amount we paid for electricity, $250. Let's do one with the other credit card, just for good measure. June 9th, charged a delivery with UPS this time for $200, and this time he put it on his Citibank credit card with this slip number or confirmation number. So now we have to go to the other card. We have to go to the Citibank card, put June 9th. The reference number is on the slip, or it's the confirmation number online. In this case, 667788. So we put 667788. In this case, the payee was UPS. And the reason for the charge was delivery expense. And the money amount of the charge was, $200. When we click record, we now have the Citibank card register showing a balance of $200. When we check the result in the trial balance, we can see that the Citibank card showed up for the first time in the trial balance as $200, but notice delivery expense has increased to $300. If we want to see an explanation of that total for delivery expense, we can double-click the number, and notice the reason why we paid a total of $300 for delivery is because we charged $100 to FedEx, $200 to UPS with the different with the two different credit cards, and that's why the total delivery expense is $300. Now let's pay down the credit cards. For example, June 10, paid Capital One $50 with check number 2 from his Chase bank account. Now let's think about this for a minute. You have two options on how to record this. You could record it as a check in the Chase bank register, or you could record it as a payment in the Capital One register. I will show you how to do it as a check in the Chase bank register, and we will see the result in the Capital One register. Let's take a look. Let's open up the Chase bank register. Let's put the date, which I believe was June 10. June 10. This was check number 2, which is what QuickBooks is suggesting. Now, whom are we paying? We're paying Capital One credit card. And for some bizarre reason, we didn't put them on the payee list, even though we should. So let's click Add New. Capital One is both a vendor and an account. So we'll click OK, and we'll type in Capital One, because that's whom we're paying. Later on, you can come back and fill this in the same way we learned in earlier videos. Click OK. And the account, now this is very important, the account that we're paying down is the Capital One credit card. And in this register, we're making a payment because we're paying from the Chase bank account to the Capital One credit card account. That's why it goes in the payment field, because it's a payment from Chase Bank. After we click record, we notice the balance of Chase Bank has decreased to $300. We can check the result in the trial balance, and we can see Chase Bank has gone down to $300, and Capital One has also gone down to $300. This very same transaction has also been copied and recorded into the Capital One register. When we open the Capital One register, we can see that the June 10th transaction with check number 2 is also listed here. And it's also listed in the payment column, making the balance of Capital One go down. We could have recorded it in this register only, and QuickBooks would have copied it into this register, and it would look exactly the same as it does here in both registers. Let's try one more, but this one we'll do in the opposite way. June 11, paid $50 to Citibank card with check number 2 from the M&T bank account. In the previous example, we recorded it in the bank account paying down the credit card. Now I will prove to you that's the same thing as putting it in the credit card register and listing which bank account it came from. Let's take a look. Let's this time open the Citibank card register, put in the information, June 11th, it was check number 2, and the payee is not on the list because in this case the payee is Citibank card. No problem, we'll click Add New, and we'll leave it on the vendor list, so we click OK, and we'll type in Citibank card, and now they're on the list. Click OK. Now, the account that the money is coming from is M&T Bank. So if we're recording a payment to Citibank card in the Citibank card register, the account we choose is the bank account it's coming from. Again, you have to make sure you record it in the payment column. I believe the amount is still $50. So we're making a payment in the Citibank card, $50. Now the balance is $150 after we click record. When we open up the M&T Bank register, we see that the transaction we just recorded in the city card register was copied into the M&T Bank register. If we look at the two registers side by side, you can clearly see that when we recorded the same transaction in the M&T Bank register, the account on the line of the transaction is the city card. When we recorded this same transaction in the city card register, the account on the line is the M&T Bank. So it doesn't matter which register you record it in as long as you record it properly. And when we look on the trial balance, we can see the results. M&T Bank is down and Citibank card balance is also down.